Minister Calvert, colleagues from the media. First of all, allow me once again to warmly welcome Minister J.P. Calvert to Indonesia. Indonesia is honored to receive your first official visit to Indonesia. And yesterday, I read the program of your visit to Indonesia, and it seems that you have a very heavy schedule and meeting so many stakeholders in Indonesia. And during the visit, the minister is accompanied by 13 strong business delegates, whom as we speak are also having a network session and exploring business opportunities with our line ministries and key business actors. Business opportunity is open, very open in Indonesia. Indonesia and Denmark share a strategic partnership that continues to flourish based on mutual respect and benefit. And on this note, allow me to congratulate Minister Calvert for the inauguration of Danish Honorary Consulate in Surabaya yesterday. Colleagues from the media, this morning Minister Calvert and I signed two agreements. This afternoon Minister Calvert and I signed two agreements, namely Indonesia-Denmark Plan of Action, a sustainable strategic partnership for the future for the period of 2021-2024, and MOU on infrastructure project financing. We are confident that the renewed POA will allow us to generate more concrete collaboration between the two countries. And now allow me to share some highlights of our meeting. First, on economic recovery. Minister Calvert and I agreed to strengthen cooperation to accelerate economic recovery. Denmark is Indonesia's second largest partner in the Nordic region for trade, investment, and tourism. Prior to the pandemic, Indonesia-Denmark trade on sustainable oil, palm oil, was a positive trajectory from $39.2 million in 2015 to $73.5 million in 2019. We agreed to continue supporting the positive contribution of sustainable palm oil to economic recovery, and I appreciate Denmark for its support toward elimination of discriminatory treatment of Indonesia agriculture products, particularly palm oil. And to further boost the post-pandemic economic recovery, I will appreciate very much for Denmark's support toward the speedy finalization of Indonesia-EU CEPA. Another areas of cooperation that we discuss is, of course, the capacity building for the startup entrepreneurs, including on the use of ICT by our startups. On investment cooperation, I hope that the signing of the MOU on the infrastructure projects financing can serve as a basis for increased finance and investment cooperation, particularly in the field of ICT, energy, transport and logistics, and maritime, as well as defense. Second is on the green partnership. Indonesia and Denmark share the importance of full and effective implementation of Paris Agreement and Glasgow Climate Pact. This is well reflected in our existing strategic sector cooperation on promoting sustainable green growth. Sustainable growth is no longer an option. It is a must. Therefore, I am very happy to see our long-standing cooperation to reduce greenhouse gas emission. In this connection, I welcome Denmark's contribution supported by the World Bank for the conservation and rehabilitation of 600,000 hectares of mangrove flats through a combination of loans and grants of up to 400 15 million Denmark kroner, or around US dollar 62.9 million. I also appreciate Denmark's support for energy transition in Indonesia through Sustainable Island Initiative programs. And I note Denmark's commitment toward the assessment of sustainable waste management, waste to energy, and biomass production in our island cities in our new plan of action. Both of us also discussed possible future cooperation in the decarbonization of shipping through the provision of green energy sources. I welcome the interest of Danish companies to invest in future new capital of Indonesia. And the third point that we discuss is on the counter-terrorism. Since 2004, Denmark has pledged their contribution to support to Jakarta Center for Law Enforcement and Cooperation, or GCLEX, activities to prevent and counter terrorism and violent extremism through various collaboration capacity building programs. And I welcome the launching of Denmark's continued support to GCLEX through the signing of Peace and Stabilization Engagement Document, a contribution of US$763,000 will be provided to GCLEX for the period of 2021-2023. Colleagues from the media, during the meeting, we also have a very frank discussion, open discussion on some global and regional issues. On the issue of Myanmar, both of us share common view on the need to restore democracy while ensuring the safety and well-being of the people of Myanmar. I underscore the importance of implementation of 5-point consensus as well as the deployment of humanitarian aid to the people of Myanmar. I also share the priorities of Indonesia presidency of G20 in 2022. So colleagues, that is all from me. And now let me invite Minister Kofod to deliver his statement. Please, Minister, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Minister Ibu Retno, for your warm welcome, for your hospitality. It is great to be here. Indonesia is a fascinating and beautiful country. Indonesia and Denmark, we are close partners and friends since we agreed to our bilateral partnership in 2015. We have systematically worked to strengthen it. And today, as you just have witnessed, we have launched a new plan of action. It's 86 points of action revolve around multilateralism and sustainability agenda by incorporating the United Nations development, Sustainable Development Goals. In it, we build and expand on our cooperation on energy, waste management, circular economy, food and agriculture, and we develop new areas. Let me give you some examples of that as well. First, we want the world to become a more green and more sustainable. In the post-pandemic recovery, we agree that the world should focus on building back better and greener. We are launching a new energy platform that doubles our efforts in the fight against climate change and promote renewable energy in the electricity mix. Minister Retno and I discussed how we can promote the green agenda together and how Indonesia will use it. It's G20 presidency in this regard as well. Both Indonesia and the Kingdom of Denmark are island nations with a similar coastline expanse. We treasure stable maritime environments and a rule-based world order on multilateral and international cooperation. Therefore, tomorrow Denmark will launch a new maritime engagement with Indonesia. It focuses on green shipping and sustainable sea transportation. We are also looking into upgrading our defense cooperation, both between authorities and industries. Indonesia and Denmark share common interests and concerns. We are democratic, open societies that share the values and benefits of tolerance, good governance, and the rule of law. Therefore, today, we are launching a new bilateral human rights dialogue. And we are supporting each other in, and promoting a mutual interest in United Nations, including the promotion of a more transparent and inclusive United Nations Security Council. We also discussed how to prevent violent extremism. And I just launched the continued Danish financial support to the Jakarta Center for Law Enforcement Cooperation. We also share the wish for the post-pandemic world to prosper through innovation, technology, commerce, and free trade to facilitate investment and technology cooperation. We just launched two memoranda. We agreed that trade and investment flows can be vastly improved under the coming Indonesia-EU Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement. And together with Minister Retno and involved agencies and companies, I now look forward to make the new plan of action concrete to the benefit of both Indonesia and Denmark in the years to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Terima kasih, teman-teman. Terima kasih.